Welcome friends to this tutorial. So in this particular tutorial I'm going to discuss how to use Google Meet, how to use it step by step on mobile as well as on desktop. So you can get various information related to Google Meet and you can use in future. First of all, what is meant by Google Meet? So it is nothing but the video communication service provided by Google. This is the video communication service provided by the Google. In Google Meet, it is the closed environment where you can conduct the meetings, discussions. Then in case of Google Meet, you can share the screen, which is or sharing screen is also available. So this facility is available in the Google Meet. Then Google Meet can be used on desktop as well as on mobile as a application or app. So those are nothing but how Google Meet is and what is the Google Meet is. In this pandemic situation, it is very much required or useful for the online teaching learning. In Google Meet, you can teach the students in the closed environment. So here I will show you how to use this Google Meet. So first of all, you have to log in into the Gmail account. So I have logged into the Gmail account. And whenever you are logging into the Gmail account, at that time you will find this Meet. Here is the option, start a Meet and join a Meet. There is other option to join the Meet or to create the Meet is you have to go to Google Apps and click on this Meet. So this is the second option. By that way or by that way, you can enter into the Google Meet. Now after entering into the Google Meet, there are two options, start a meeting or enter meeting code. So whenever you are the host, at that time you must use start a meeting. And whenever you are joining to the meeting which is already created by somebody else, so he will send a meeting code. You have to put that meeting code here and then you have to join. So first, start meeting means you are the host, and in case of other is host and you are joining the meeting, at that time you have to enter the meeting code and then join. Now click on the start a meeting. Now it will take some time and saying getting ready. Now the meeting is ready, you can click on join now. Share this information with the people, because if you are looking at this particular point, you will find that there is only one member, that is the person who is nothing but me. So this particular code you have to copy. So directly you can copy. So copy meeting link. This meeting link you have to send it to the persons whom you want to join into your meeting. Otherwise you can add the people from your contact list. So I have copied it and I am sending it to the other person. Okay, so that person will join by clicking there. The person will ask to join. So now someone wants to join this meeting. So you can deny the entry or you can admit. Now you want to conduct the meeting, so you can admit it. Admit. Now other person is joined. Now here you can see there are two persons. Now what are the various options in meeting? Hello. Now I will show you what are the various options available in this particular Google Meet. So there are two persons. So you can see that two persons. There are multiple people also available. Now whenever I am talking, whatever I am talking, that will be available to that particular person. In this case, I don't have now camera on, or video will be available on my meeting. Now other options are, you can present whatever on your screen. So you can click on present now. So you can present your entire screen, a window or Chrome tab. This Chrome, so I am putting or clicking on entire screen. Click on this, then share. So now you are presenting your screen, and that screen will be available on other's device. So whatever you are doing at that particular place, it is available on that particular meeting. You can stop sharing. Now other option is, in case of present, you can present a window also, a window. So whatever window you want to share, then click on it and share. Now this particular window is available on others device, and here you will find the three things, means you are the host, this is the person who has joined, and your presentation. You can stop sharing. Few more options are. Now the best option for present now, it may be Chrome tab in case of video and animation. So you have to click on that Chrome tab. Okay, cancel. You can open new Chrome tab and then you can share. So that will be better. Best, new tab. Okay, share. So this particular tab I have shared with the person from other end. Now suppose I want to share my YouTube channel. So this particular channel is shared with the other person. If suppose I want to share or I want to play some video, then I can play this video. So this video is also available on the other person's device, and the audio will be very clear. So I am closing it. You can stop this. Now what are other options available? So you can click here. You can change the layout. Click on this change layout. Spotlight means only the single person. If you want to see persons who are in your meeting, so you can see here. So this is the presentation screen, and those are the persons available. There is other option, so you can see all the people who are in this particular meeting. If the number of persons are more, then it small picture will be displayed. In this case there are only two, then you can click on full screen. So this is the full screen for the Google Meet. You can remove or you can exit from the full screen. You can turn on captions. So whatever I am talking, it may be displayed as a captions, so you can turn off the captions. Then the persons can chat with you. So here they can chat. Hi. So other person is also chat with you. Now suppose I am removing the person from the meeting, then I can remove. You can have that remove from the meeting. So remove, the person will be removed, our person was removed. Now only one person. I will close the meeting, close it. Then from here you can close. The meeting is over. So this is about how we can conduct the Google Meet and how it will be useful.